Bill Gross's gigantic PIMCO Total Return Fund bounced back from a horrible 2011 to return more than 10% last year. But investment advisor Steve Goldberg, partner Twaddell Goldberg Investment Management, says it's time to sell the world's largest bond fund. Well, Steve, total return placed in the top 12% of its class last year. That was more than double its benchmark. So why sell it? I mean, besides this Bill Gross, the bond king that you're talking about.
It's not like Bill Gross has suddenly gotten stupid, and it's not like he doesn't have a lot of smart people working with him. He does. But the problem is he's got a portfolio now with 20,000 securities. So to my mind, he's like a very good boxer fighting with one hand behind his back. And what that means is he can't win by picking cheap bonds. He can't spend the time looking inside a company, looking inside its finances and say, boy, this is a really good bond. It's way underappreciated by the market. I want to buy it. The only thing he can do is get the macro right, get that big picture right. And he has to be superb at that.
But isn't size less of a problem with bond funds since the market's much bigger and the prices are less sensitive to big volume trades?
Yeah, but I don't think you've ever had a stock fund that's approached $300-400 billion in assets. When Peter Lynch was managing, I think his fund was $20 billion. I mean, there are funds that have been $100 billion, even as close as $200 billion before they've lagged on the stock side. But on the bond fund, I don't think there's ever been a fund as big as PIMCO Total.
Isn't the fund relatively nimble and properly positioned given that Gross has shortened his duration?
Well, he can shorten his duration. You can go into the futures market and do that any time of the day or night. But what he can't do is pick the good undervalued bonds like a fund like MetWest Unconstrained or MetWest Total Return, or a whole bunch of Double Line Total Return can do that. Some of his own firm's funds. PIMCO Diversified Income is one of my favorites. And PIMCO Income is a good fund too. These are in the $20 billion range, and they can pick that really good, superb. It's just like in stock land.
Well, Steve, in addition to the point you made about size, you also make a point in the article that perhaps this time the 30-year bond rally is over. What makes you so sure that this time it is over? Because this time last year we heard the same arguments and the bond still rallied.
Yeah, I mean, 30 years is a long time for a bull market in bonds. It's pretty close to the end. And at this point, you're going to have to be really nimble to make, because you're going to have to make money in some of these smaller sectors. So you go into junk bonds and you've got to pick up a really good junk bond. You go into convertibles. I think Bill Gross's fund is bigger than all of the convertible securities that are available in the U.S.
So what would you recommend that investors pick up instead of the total return fund?
I think everybody's shortening up their duration, their exposure to interest rates, because everybody realizes rates can't go down but so much. And in order to make money in the bond market, you've got to look in some other areas. The best areas, I think, are emerging markets. And secondly, I'd put mortgages, some of the private mortgages, the same stuff that caused the blow up in 08. The stuff, some of it's selling pretty cheap still.
All right. Thanks a lot, Steve, for joining us. Our thanks to Steve Goldberg of Twaddell Goldberg Investment Management. I'm Fred Kantayama, and this is Reuters.